shalt thou live, and thou shalt serve thy brother. And it shall come to pass, when thou shalt have the dominion, that thou shalt break his yoke from off thy neck. Hallelujah. If thou shalt break the yoke off thy neck. Genesis chapter number 25, verse 31. It starts from verse 25 anyway. Genesis 25, verse 29. And I read. And Jacob sought pottage, and saw Esau came from the field, and he was faint. And Esau said to Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with the same red pottage, for I am faint. Therefore was his name called Edom. And Jacob said, sell me this day thy birthright. And Esau said, behold, I am at the point to die. And what profit shall this birthright do to me? And Jacob said, swear to me this day, and give me, and swear, and he swear unto him, and he said, and he sold his birthright unto Jacob. Underline that word. And he sold his birthright unto Jacob. And Jacob gave Esau bread and pottage of lentils. And he did eat and drink, and rose up and went his way. Thus Esau despised his birthright. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And I pray, Masama, Minewu Channel, Maturi, he said, you can change the trend. Hallelujah. Na ye nimsa abako semi ya DNA see. Bible say there were two people who were, there were two brothers. In fact, they were twins. Na omu eye and tafo. Now one was a hunter. He's gone to the farm, he's gone to do his work, and he's come back. And he was hungry. I'm talking about Esau. Esau was the oldest one, and he was the one with the birthright. He was the one that had the power, the upper hand. And Jacob was the younger one. Hallelujah. Jacob was in the house, and the Bible says that he has prepared some food. And when Esau came in, the Bible says that Esau was so hungry, and he requested for food. Hallelujah. And at that time, Jacob told Esau, that look, my brother, if you want some of my food, then you need to give me your birthright. Let's look at what Jacob said at that time. Jacob said, I am hungry and I'm at the point of dying. What has birthright got to do for me? Hallelujah. What has birthright got to do with for me? So he gave his birthright in the returns for food. Hallelujah. He said, look, I am going to die. So if I don't get some food to eat, I will die. So the Bible says that Jacob, Esau, sold his birthright, gave his birthright to Esau, to Jacob, for food. Hallelujah. He sold his birthright. Now he said, look, swear today, swear to me that you have sold your birthright to me. Hallelujah. And the Bible says that Esau swore and he gave the birthright to Jacob. And I pray, Asembakwa miwa ekane say, you can change the trend. You can change the trend. Now, as a result of that, the birthright went to Jacob. Because whatever has been agreed upon, whatever has been said on that day, has been captured by the spirit, and by nature, it has taken place. Hallelujah. He said, I'm at the point of death, and therefore give me some food to eat. And he said, what is birthright? What has birthright to God to do for me? At that point, Esau did not recognize how important the birthright was. At that point, Esau did not value the birthright that he was carrying. He didn't know the essence. He didn't know the power that comes with position. He didn't know the power that comes with authority. Jacob underrated the power that he was carrying as the birthright of the family, as the birthright of the family. He didn't know the power behind it. He was carrying the power of God. Esau was carrying the grace and the mantle of God. He was carrying the blessings of God as the first son. He was carrying all the knowledge and all the great things that God has bestowed upon the family and the people of Israel and even to the whole wild world. Hallelujah. Therefore, at that point, because of hunger, because the brother was hungry, a hunger that he couldn't stand, a hunger that was killing him, he said, I'm at the point of death. And I asked myself, so this brother was going to die. Is that true? But because of the things of the flesh, he sold the birthright unto his brother. Hallelujah. My brother, my sister who is hearing me today, many of us are going through difficult times. Many of us are going through hard times. Not because of our doing. And your body be now ya. Yemu be brani ya ko apiniyemu. Yemu be brani ya wo ahuchiremu. Yemu be brani niyaman ko ya mayai. A enya yemfumswa. And your body be now ya. And then ya sembi no akachire nyame. Ne mom, it has got a cause. It has its roots somewhere. Ewa ni fabai, ewa ni fapim, ewa baby. There is a cause to the troubles and the problems that you are going through. Some of us is not because of our sin. Some of us is not because of our nature. Some of us, we are struggling. Your brain not because of anything that you have done. But the roots, the source comes from somewhere. Anopai, you can change the trend, my brother, my sister. You can change the trend that you are going through. So the Bible says that right from the day that Esau sold his birthright to Jacob, you know, Jacob took authority over Esau. Ye nanalum binomo, ye papa binomo. Our grandfathers, our grandmothers, our great-great-grandfathers know. Some of us, some of them have sold the birthright of the family to the enemy. They have exchanged the blessings of God from the family with another family. They have exchanged the goodness that the Lord bestowed upon the family. You know, your great-grandfather has sold it to another family. Has sold it to another class of people. And it right from the beginning, right from the time of your great-grandfather, there has been struggle throughout your life. There has been problems throughout your life. This morning, I'm here to let you know that you can change the trend. You can change whatever trend that is going on in the family. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, somebody. Because of food, Esau did not know how important the birthright was. Because of hunger, he sold his birthright to his brother Esau. Now look at Jesus Christ. When he was hungry, the devil came to him and he said, look, if you can turn the stone into bread, you will be blessed. The enemy knows what the family needs. The enemy knows what the family needs. So he will bring what the family needs, even to tempt, to exchange the glory of the family. Some of you are going through poverty, not because of your doing, but because your family or your grandfather has sold the goodness of the family in exchange of money. Not there was money, there was riches in the family. But before they can go on successfully, before they can get childbirth, they have to go and exchange the riches in the family for children. And don't you know how much they they've gone to the Bami Abosunso Ako exchange it with children. So you realize that everyone and now so papa no so bad in your rano. Oh yeah, your friend, oh yeah, it has taken dominion of the family, it has taken prominence of the family. And until one and now went through poverty, and until papa went through poverty, and you are also going through poverty. You look at your brothers, you look at your sisters, you know. When you were sitting in Osika, Obiera struggled with poverty. But I'm here to let you know that you can change the trend. You can change that trend of your grandfathers. You can make the change come in your time. Some of you, a lady was telling me the other day, Sir, Omabu Shenadier, not they were rich, not Omu Wosika. Now, you talk about marriage, you know, there was no marriage in the family. And man, Omabu Shenadier, no, Omunyinara, Awaria, and Kosuye, and Momu. They look at the grandmother, they look at the mother herself, or Shenadier, Munyinara, Awaria, if you are ready, a bin near Bushenimo. Now one day she called her grandmother and she interacted with the grandmother and she realized that not only great grandmothers, no, not a warrior we see anymore, but not there was poverty. And not only I can say, almost bread too much, they were struggling as a family. And not only call Abosunso and the almost sick and almost Eko extendi, omu di oma wari ano eko extendi for sika. And uti from the grandmother, no, great grandmother time no be seen ano. I mean poverty there is out of the family. Now so awari friend awari there, a bintina a busheni mo. Maybe you come from that family. Maybe you are of that family. Say awari friend awari there, a bo sa busheno. When you are not paying for money, you are marrying in another. Oma umiensa, oma wonai, oma umienu. Now, so awaria friend, awaria dear, omunibi. I have good news for you this morning. You can change the trend of the family. You can change whatever has been started, or you can change whatever that is going on. I spoke to somebody, and I catch them, sir. Media and you know the abo abusiano. You look at the family, no? Yenina and you know the obibiera nibi. Aya kwenza from kwa. Obia niwa. Asamto ukrapa obetu mi afano edi wechi songo kwa semao. Omu nyinara abusiani nyinara. Akoya kwenza from kwa. It can be, sir. Their grandmothers, their grandfathers, no? Took their life into somewhere or into the bosom so, and they've gone to exchange something, and as a result of that, you know, they are going through drunkenness. You can change the trend, my brother. You can change the trend, my sister. And you may cause your brother bosom so, and then you never and your fault. There are some people talk about illness. talk about yaria akoso. De biara omwo some type of sickness bi omo busia mo. Anya diabetes a. Na aye high blood pressure. Anya high blood pressure. Na aye rheumatism. Talk about illness yaria biara ko ba biara no. Ebi wo busia ne mo. It can be said it is not your fault. It can be said it is something that has come from your grandmothers and your grandfathers. And it's still going, it's still trending. And you have passed it on to your daughters. You have passed it on to your sons. And you have are going through sicknesses. One sickness upon another sickness. It can be that they have sold their birthright to somebody else. They have exchanged your birthright as a family with something small. This morning I want you to know that you can change the trend. The Bible says that Esau went to the stand of swearing to exchange his birthright for food. He said, I'm hungry to the stand. I'm hungry to the stand that I'm going to die. But give me some food and I will not die. Are you listening to me? Are you hearing my voice this morning? I pray that God will change the trend of the family. You will change the trend. Your time will be changed. From your time onwards, you will not experience that. I will say you are. I'm not the only abawo. I buy from the bad year. I be near bushy anymore. I'm a banana banana. I'm a who na banana. And it is a trend. It's going on. Your grandmother, your grandfather. I'm going to stay the beer no more free moon. And I it continues going on. Akoso. Uba wuya uba no so free moon. You can change the trend, my brother. You can make a change to that destiny. You can make a change. Hallelujah. Maybe your grandfather has sold any nyansa I webusue ni muno. Or be assistant for money. It, as a result of that, nyansa biara ni ebusue ni mo. Maybe the family is going through a lack of blessing. Ebi enshire from the shirano. Ebi ni ebusue ni mo. Munyina yaka yedia. Obia nibi. Munyina yaka yedia. Ebusue ni mo bia nyanya yedie. Because your birthright has been sold. Now in the Bible there was a man called Naboth. Bible says that there was a king called Ahab. Ahab needed the vineyard of Naboth. But Naboth, who said the vineyard in his possession, you know, was not his personal thing. You know, Ahab wanted Naboth to sell the land, the property of the family, you know, to him, the king. But Naboth said something. He said, God, that one we can find from the book of 1 Kings chapter 21. He said, God forbid that I will sell the family property to you as a king. As a result of that, Naboth was killed. My brother, that you are listening to me, some of our elders have sold the birthright of the families. Some of our grandparents have sold the birthright. Something that was generating money. Something that was generating blessing to the family. No, they have sold it out to another family. And as a result of that, and Kwalani Ginara, you are struggling. This morning the Lord will bless somebody. This morning you can change the trend. It doesn't matter what has happened in the past. It doesn't matter what the devil has done in the past. It doesn't matter whatever the family has gone through. You can bring a change to the family. You can change the situation. You can change the trend. Some of your fathers, some of your grandmothers, they had to just bow to the devil because of some troubles, because of some hunger. Watom abusua na japade nyinara. Watom adubusua na nyansa nyinara. Watom nyama a na ka edi yebie ebabusua no mo. And as a result of that, you are struggling. You can change the trend, my brother. You can recover anything that the devil has taken from you. People are struggling. People are suffering. They didn't think about the future. Oh man, doing that. Oh man, doing that. All that they thought was what now. They thought about now that a common no go through no. Sadam a common now. Iso a go through no. And no quan and or dream home. And no tin nyama amid autonomy and that one in some. And no tin shira ne kutano. And no tia duma na kaze piano soup that you know. Iso has to sell it out. Because of hunger. Yenananu bia tong ye japadia. Yenananu bia tong abusiani yansam. Yenananu bia tong abusiani shira. And number koma na edi womo. And number koma na omu go through. Something that even wouldn't have killed them. But Iso said, I am in a point of death. Akakra na mewu. And uti wa mamye janina mewu. Now I ask myself, sir, naka Jacob ama Iso janina. Naka Iso obewu ampana. The answer is no. I believe that our grandfathers, our great grandmothers, you know, omu antong ye amye abusyene japadye. And then can all that so I go through that hunger now. Like the family will still be blessed by now. Like the family will still be blessed by now. He said, look, sell the birthright to me quickly now. And he was not sure. Esau was not sure about the future. Esau did not think about the future. Esau did not think about what the Lord has entrusted into his hands. And therefore he has to sell the birthright. For just a Djani Kakra. A Djani Kakra, he sold the power of God. He sold the authority of God. He sold the blessings of God unto Jacob. And he wanted to satisfy himself. He wanted to satisfy himself. Look at the blessings. Now, so after some years, after some time, the Bible says that Isaac loved Jacob. I don't want to rush to read it. We can find that one in the verse 28 and 29. Isaac wanted to bless, Esau. So he called Esau, and as a result of that, Jacob got to hear of the information. Jacob came in, and he was blessed by Isaac. Jacob was blessed by Isaac. Now look at the blessings that Isaac blessed Jacob. He said, look, the verse 28 and 29, he said, the dew of heaven will come upon you. You will have the dew of heaven. All the blessings of heaven will come upon you, Jacob. All the blessings I have will come upon you. You will receive the fatness of this earth. Hallelujah. This was the blessing that a man was pouring upon his son. But because the birthright has gone to another son, Isaac thought he was blessing Jacob. But because the birthright has been sold to Isaac, to Jacob, sorry, Jacob received the blessings on behalf of Esau. He said, look, you will receive corn and wine. People shall serve you. The whole world, the whole nations shall bow to you. Even you will be your brother and his family will bow to you. You will be lord over your brother. Others will bow to you. You will be in charge of the whole universe. Hallelujah. So the Bible says that at that time, Jacob received the Bami. Jacob received the blessings on behalf of Esau. My brother, my sister, the blessings that God has got for you and your brothers, according baby, anything I will struggle, anything I will tete, anything I brabone enkoye. Now the Bible says that when Esau came into the house and he realized that the blessings has gone to Jacob, the Bible says that he cried. He cried so hard. And he cried. And he wept bitterly. And he said, This is the two times. This is the second time. You look at it, verse 36. Genesis chapter number 27, verse 36. I said, this is the second time that my brother has cheated upon me. This is the second time that my brother has taken my blessings. The first time my brother took away my birthright. And the second time he has taken away my blessings. Now I ask myself the questions. Did your brother take away your blessings or you sold? Did your brother take away your birthright or you sold your birthright? Did your brother take away the authority or you exchanged the blessings or you exchanged the authority? So the Bible says that Esau was in tears. And Esau asked the father, he said, Father, is there no blessings for me? Is there no more blessings for me? He cried. He cried and he wept. He felt sorry because he realized that the blessings has gone to another family. He realized that all that was left was surplus. And don't you know who said? It is going to have effect on him. Not only himself, but he and his descendants. So the Bible says that Esau cried. And he went before his father. He said, Father, bless me one more time. Father, give me the last blessings that you have. And the father said, if you shall strengthen yourself, if you will be strong enough, if you work this out, you will be able to take off the yoke from your neck. Hallelujah. It will take the power of God to break the yoke. It will take more effort to break the yoke. It will take more power to break the yoke. You can change the trend. The trend that your fathers and your mothers have gone through. And you may have yet the trend that become the order of the family. Look back and look at what is going on in the family. Tewanisha Abusianimo, Tewanisha Unana, Tewanisha Unahumami, Tewanisha Upapa. Look at the problem that is going through. It's moving from one stage to the other, it's moving from one generation to the other. But I'm here to let you know that you can change the trend, you can change whatever is going on. You can change the trend. You can change whatever the devil has started in the family. You can change whatever is going on in the family. You can make a change. Say, Adia Weninjehu. Say, Adia Wawunim, sir. It's something that is happening in the family. Then my brother, you can change the thing. Then my sister, you can make a change. But it will take the struggle. It will take the power of God. It will take your strength. It will need your commitment. It will need your power. It will need your effort. Think about those things. Think about what is going on in the family. Think about whatever is happening. Think about what your father went through. Think about what you are going through. Think about what your mother went through. Think about what your sisters are going through. Think about what your brothers are going through. And know that there is something going on in the family. My brother, you can change the trend. It doesn't matter how many years that thing has happened. It doesn't matter what the devil has done in the family. I'm here to encourage you. I'm here to let you know that you can really change the trend. It's never too late for you to change what is happening. The poverty can stop. Oh, the disappointment can stop. The blessings will start again. If only and only you will stand strong. If only you hold on to your faith and know that you can make a change. That you can make a change. My brother, the Bible says that we are not fighting against flesh and blood, but we are fighting against principalities. We are fighting against powers. So as a result of that, it's not just eating and drinking, but you need to commit yourself. You need to fight for your family. You need to stand for your family. You need to pray for your family. You need to say enough is enough. I was told in a painting, now we can say enough is enough. I don't want my family to go through again. I don't want my children to go through again. You can cease that. You can stop the trend. You can stop whatever has been going on. Say to yourself, enough is enough. Say to yourself that God, it is time. It is time for a change. It is time for a change. Be strong, my brother. Be strong, my sister. And change the trend. Hold on to your faith. Jina upiti, jina u, I mean, so upiti, so ujidye muye. Jina piti, ne so ujidye muye. Ne jina homa wabusya. Bompa yama wabusya. Dima wabusya. Dima wabusya. Pray. Be strong. And know that you can change the trend. Nyami onshira bibri. Nyami onkeumu. Nyami om tre ushiemu. Adie bia who go through. Ti bie biera who go swa enko ye. Adie biera abaya kurankro. Adie biera abaya busya atedia abaya family property. Start is what I've been saying in the mukano. Awariena enko ye no. You can make a change. Awariena asaye no. You can make a change. Oh, yana wa busya ni mono. You can make a change. Me se niamana asaye wa busya ni mono. You can stop it. Katina wusa, not for you and your children. Wumadia, they will not go through that poverty. Wumadia, they will receive the blessings of God. Nani nyinara ebe jina wusu. Ano pa iso obet me jina pinti yi. Nua bompaye. Nua kentine wuhu. Upe timia yunkundi ano. Efri ebushyeni mu. Upe timia yusa ahuchira no. Efri obushyeni mu. Upe timia daninia unanano mu. You can stop it. Nyami shira onye okashie mempa ibone se onu nyami obako umwa na nyama akosu na wintimi nane no onu nyami na nkasa on dane fama. Stay blessed and receive the power of God. Nyami onshira bibre. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Somebody, your number is 0788406.